Welcome, everyone. My name is Ricardo Camacho, and thank you for joining us today for this webinar to go over the must-haves in CI/CD software development for embedded. Before we get started, if for some reason your screen resolution does not seem correct, know that there are some display resolution settings in BrightTalk that you can actually adjust. Anyways, this is going to be a very informative presentation, so let's take a look at the agenda. To put things in perspective and give you a glance and hopefully broad scope of understanding related to modern agile development workflows, I'm going to start with putting agile in context and how that relates to team collaboration and methodologies used. Then how DevOps and continuous integration and continuous delivery actually fits into this picture. And I'll step you through a very quick description of each of the stages in the DevOps workflow to do this. Now, then we're going to have a demo and you get to actually see this in action. Now, these demonstrations rely on internet connectivity, and since our product manager is Miroslav Zielinski, is in Europe and far away from San Diego, California, where I'm at, we have decided to record that portion of the presentation. The demo will take us through a live CI/CD workflow, starting from writing code to delivering it using our new and exciting GitLab integration with Parasoft's CC++ test automation solution. It's going to be very educational. And then what we'll do at the end is we're going to open it up for Q&A. So let's go ahead and get started. Starting with a little history on Agile, back in 2001, a group of folks with various software development backgrounds met, and they discussed the different software development practices at the time, like extreme programming, if you remember that. I actually remember going through that with a partner, and it was interesting. It was kind of useful. But anyways, there was other development practices like feature-driven development. To cut it short, they came up with what is known as the Agile Manifesto. They realized that there were these overarching values related to how people should collaborate internally and externally within an organization, and not just to develop better software, but to actually help each other develop better software. So they came up with these four rules that you actually see here and the 12 principles to establish the agile mindset that you should have, or the philosophy that you should adopt. As you get familiar with the rules and principles, a theme around interactions, collaboration, cooperation is actually going to emerge. And this is key because a core component of Agile is breaking the silos within teams and organizations and have them work closely together. And another core value is responding to change, which is important, and it's supported by principles number one and number three, which are about continuous delivery and delivering software frequently. So there's like a couple components here. There is the groups and the people and the organization, and then there's also the tools and the solutions to also help achieve that. So these core values and principles can be found in the way things are done in Scrum, Kanban, DevOps, and others. Note that these methodologies support agile values and principles, therefore they are correctly referred as agile methodologies. So a point I want to make across is that Scrum is agile, but agile is not Scrum. Agile is not a methodology. I wanted to make this point because sometimes there's a lot of confusion out there. If not all of you, most of you are familiar with the Scrum project management methodology, so I'm not going to go into complete detail. We use it here at Parasoft for our software development, and it brings cross-functional teams together to work towards a common product vision and goals in delivering our solutions with openness, transparency, and respect. We have sprint meetings to synchronize. In these meetings, we determine what is being delivered, what didn't get done or completed, and needs to go to the backlog. We also check if any requirements change and how to manage that change. And this is really important. And there are also roles that people play within Scrum. So So you have Scrum Master, Product Owners, and so on and so forth. Anyways, in a nutshell, Scrum promotes a smarter way of working that allows the teams to accomplish more within a given time frame, and what is being delivered is actually becomes fairly predictable, which is a very nice thing. The ideal Scrum team is a group of highly flexible and adaptive individuals who thrive in the context of an iterative and incremental delivery structure, and they're not afraid to also give and receive feedback, because that's important. You also have Kanban, which again is very much about teamwork and very human interaction driven, all for the purpose to better support collaboration between people. I've been to companies where walls in meeting rooms are filled with post-its from them having had a planning meeting. It's actually a pretty cool sight. So Scrum and Kanban are popular agile methodologies in support of people working together. But what about software development methodologies incorporating tools and automation in support of agile? That's really, really important. You have DevOps just for that reason. Automation and tools with steps or stages that enable continuous integration and continuous delivery. It automates the software development process by managing all the tasks that people are working on while also keeping it all together in a copacetic order. Putting it in a few words, DevOps mechanizes and automates manual tasks. It breaks down team silos and increases productivity. It complements Scrum. So anyways, but I'm sure you have all seen the infinity symbol with the various stages in development, which graphically represents a continuous and iterative approach. I'll very quickly describe each stage and also illustrate some of the tooling that is commonly used in embedded development. But before I do so, I'm going to draw the bridge between agile methodologies and industry functional safety standards like ISO 26262 for automotive, and you will find that the same exists for other standards like IEC 62304 for medical, DO178 for avionics, IEC 61508 for industrial automation, and there are several other functional safety standards out there. So within these standards, you will find a V-model diagram expressing each of the software development phases. Here's an example of a V-model graphic. It captures the software development lifecycle phases that embedded safety and security systems need to go through. On the left-hand side, you have requirements analysis, then high and low level design, and then implementation. On the right, you have the various verification validation phases for each of the abstraction levels in the software development lifecycle. For example, static analysis can be performed before any code execution. Then you have unit testing, integration system, and acceptance testing at the top. The V-model is not a methodology. The V-model is used, again, by these standards to express a required set of development phases that need to be performed in order to achieve that maximum safety level of assurance. So these safety standards describe what needs to be done, but understand that they stay away from how it should be done. The how is left up to the organization to decide. So it won't state that you have to use the waterfall methodology or spiral or DevOps. It's left completely up to you. You get to choose the best fit for what works. For example, I've been in projects that are actually very small embedded pieces of software, and you have one or two engineers working on it, and the waterfall methodology works the best. It just does. They can communicate right away and get things done. For bigger, large projects, you know, something like DevOps is just absolutely crucial. So understand that you have to look at your project. Anyways, here is an example of the ISO 26262 V model diagram used in the automotive industry to express, again, required development phases to go through, which, again, ensures that you are delivering a very safe and secure system. Okay, let's get back to DevOps. Continuous integration is where software development begins, and it will typically iterate several times before code is ever deployed. This happens on the left side of the infinity, and it involves tools that automate the workflow. Here you see the infinity adorned with various development tools. Remember that all these tools working together help satisfy this whole agile methodology. Code editors like VS Code, Eclipse, archiving tools like Git, test tools like C++ tests, compilers like GCC, CMakes, and perhaps you also use containers like Docker. There is Jira for project management, among other things, and there are many other DevOps solutions like GitHub, Azure, and GitLab, which we will be seeing in the actual demo. All right, let's step through some of these stages. Planning is the first stage. Here you identify your requirements and what you're going to deliver at the end of each iteration. Jira is arguably one of the most popular tools for agile project management. Then, of course, you start coding. Code is where the engineers work off of their own development branch, not to disrupt the well-tested and working main development branch. Here I'm showing configuration management tools like Git and IDEs like VS Code, Eclipse, and actually Parasoft C++ test is integrated into these also IDEs so that you can start analyzing and fixing code as you write it and before you actually do your build. However, then you have build, and build is the next stage, which gets triggered by committing or pushing the code. Here the code is compiled and built. Again, automation is a core part of DevOps. So these tools that you see here can be integrated or have been integrated into various degrees. And there are other things to consider, such as the use of Docker containers and or other types of containers that you may have in your organization. Upon a successful build, test automation is again automatically invoked. Test methods like static analysis, unit testing, regression testing, structural code coverage, and all of those things can be performed. Parasoft C++ test easily integrates into this automated CI pipeline, as actually Merrick is going to demonstrate in the demo. And he actually is going to keep it to static analysis in the interest of time, but know that you can do lots of various types of testing. Release is the next stage, and that is based on the success of your testing. If no bugs are found, the code is then or can then be merged into the main branch. You want to make sure that that main branch is always sound and healthy. Now, imagine multiple engineers working in parallel in this automated continuous integration cycle until you have an actual version of an application to deliver. Remember that you also have Scrum coordinating and the collaboration between people and teams within the organization. Now, moving into the next stage, we are now delving into continuous delivery. You see the word deploy, but in embedded development, particularly for safety and security critical applications, there is typically an approval process, such as acquiring compliance and certification. Now, this is commonly done for medical devices, avionics systems, safety modules for automotive applications, and for many other embedded systems. You know, our organizations cannot just deploy code out into the field, as it is commonly done in enterprise IT, for example, in web applications. However, since Parasoft supports testing of both embedded and enterprise types of applications, we've kept the deploy in the infinity diagram. Also, I've put some logos of tools, solutions that help in delivering and deploying applications to at least just give you some examples there. Now, operate is the stage where the application or system is now live and being used by customers, and your organization is making sure that everything is running smoothly. Monitor is the next stage where field or customer feedback is collected and you also take the opportunity to go back, look at the inefficiencies that exist in the pipeline or in the workflow, the process, and you go ahead and make the necessary fixes and corrections. And also that feedback from the field or customers can be incorporated into the planning. So again, it starts the cycle, starts again. Okay, let's get to the demo and see DevOps continuous integration in action. This is going to be fantastic.
Hello. In this video, I will demonstrate how Parasoft C++ test integrates into GitLab CI/CD pipelines. We're going to see how easy it is to create a GitLab pipeline with C++ test static analysis, how to access static analysis results in the GitLab interface, and how to download results from GitLab's pipeline to Visual Studio Code for convenient remediation. For the demonstration, I will use a GitLab account with a repository for the demo project, a Linux workstation with Parasoft C++ test, GNU GCC compiler, and Visual Studio Code Editor, which will serve as a development host, and a GitLab runner for executing the pipelines. During the demonstration, we're going to go through the following steps: defining a GitLab pipeline with the C++ test static analysis, and then simulating a simple use case, which will include developer pulling the code from the repository, modifying it and pushing to GitLab. The push operation will trigger the pipeline, which will launch C++ test to perform static analysis. Static analysis results will be published and available in GitLab's interface for inspection. And developer will download GitLab's pipeline results into VS Code for convenient remediation. I will switch now to my development machine and open the browser with my GitLab account where I have my demo project. This is a timer example that is shipped with C++ test. Let me clone my repository. I will do it using VS Code. We're ready to start development now. The next thing we want to do is to configure the pipeline. For pipeline execution, we'll need a GitLab runner, which I have already configured. As you can see here, it's already running, waiting for jobs to execute, and we're ready to define our pipeline. To do so, let's switch to GitLab CI/CD section and select Editor. Here we can define a new pipeline. We'll ignore the default template and copy one of the example pipelines that are publicly available in the GitLab. Let me switch to the Parasoft's GitLab account to cpptest-gitlab project. Here you can find a lot of useful information regarding C++ test integration with GitLab, including the example pipelines. I will open now one of the pipeline examples that features static analysis and copy it to the pipeline for the demo project. Before I commit the pipeline, let's take a quick look. The pipeline includes two stages: build and test. Here you can see the CMake invocation to generate the build scripts and build the code. At this step, compile commands JSON file is generated, which will be used as an input for the static analysis. Once the code is built, static analysis is executed in the test stage using cpptest CLI interface. Here you can see the cpptest CLI invocation. The project will be scanned with the preselected configuration of static analysis checkers called recommended rules. Users can choose other pre-configured selections of checkers such as MISRA, CERT or AUTOSAR, or create their own selections. Above, you can see some additional C++ test options specified to configure the analysis. One of the options enables GitLab SAST report, which will be uploaded to GitLab once the analysis finishes. We're ready to commit the pipeline now. Let's add a short comment and commit the file. Our new commit immediately triggered the pipeline. And as you can see, the build job is already in progress. And now the static analysis job is running. It will finish in a minute. When the pipeline completes, the SAST report is uploaded to GitLab and the results are presented in the Security and Compliance Vulnerability Report. Let's drill down and take a quick look. Here we can see a summary which shows the total number of violations for each criticality level. It helps developers to attack the problems, starting with the most critical issues. Below we can see the list of all reported findings. Each violation is presented with a short summary and an ID that indicates which static analysis rule was violated. Here is a violation of the rule Avoid Accessing Arrays Out of Bounds. When I click it, a more detailed view is displayed, which includes a step-by-step explanation of the problem. We can easily click any element of the stack trace and see problem in the context of the source code. C++ test integration with GitLab provides a great value here. The ability to review code scanning results directly in GitLab, either in the context of a specific check-in or as a part of the merge request, streamlines the development workflows and reduces the cost of the compliance process with industry standards. In some situations, however, when remediating complex problems or working with larger batches of violations, it may be more convenient to download the findings to the IDE and continue working there. C++ Tests extension for VS Code integrates with GitLab and enables accessing pipeline's results directly in the editor, which is a great productivity feature that simplifies results analysis and remediation. So let me download my pipeline's results now. As you can see, now I have GitLab's pipeline results available in the problems view of my VS Code. And I'm ready to start working on these results. So let me fix one of the problems. Here we want to make sure that buffer is not the reference before checking for null. And let's say that this issue we do not consider as a problem and we want to suppress it. Let's assume that we are done for now and that we want to commit changes and push them to GitLab. Our push operation triggered the pipeline. Let's give it a minute to finish and check results. And this concludes my demonstration. We just covered how easy it is to create a GitLab pipeline with C++ test static analysis, how to access static analysis results in the GitLab interface, and how to use Parasoft VS Code extension to improve productivity when working with static analysis findings. Thank you for watching.
You got to see a great DevOps workflow presentation, and Parasoft actually keeps making it easier and better all the time. We're always making amazing improvements and future enhancements. Anyways, as you can see on the right side of the slide, I've placed some QR codes on other videos that show C++ integrated with Azure DevOps and GitHub. So if you're using those DevOps tools, you have some videos that you can go reference. Now, if you want to learn more about C++ tests, request a custom in-depth demo. You can see the QR code on the left-hand side. Or if you want, send us an email at info@parasoft.com. Also, you can find us and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. Okay, I'm now going to open things up for Q&A. We have one question here. Can you provide any improvement info or metrics on adopting CI/CD? I don't have any metrics. I've seen some numbers, but it's hard to share those kinds of things. But this is a very valid question. So the best way I can respond is what I've heard, what I've noticed from customers from the field. And you know, many of our customers are moving towards DevOps, or already have actually adopted DevOps, and so they come to us to incorporate the test automation into their pipeline. And what the ones that have had it for many years, what they've been saying is that they can better predict the delivery of software. And that they've been able to also better accommodate the changes in the requirements and changes that happen in the design. So it's a lot more organized, and it happens actually quicker. But the biggest tell is that they mentioned that there is a drop in QA problem reports and also customer tickets. And what this equates to really is a lower cost in testing and development, because they're, you know, the product that they're putting out into the field is just of higher quality. And you know, this increase in quality, it also equates to lower cost in testing and development, and also time to market. Anyway, that's all the time we have. If you have any questions, please feel free to email us at info@parasoft.com or go to the Parasoft website. We have tons of informative content. Also, if you happen to be attending Embedded World this year, please visit us at our booth for questions. And if you would like, we will give you a personalized demo. I thank you very much for attending this presentation, and I hope you found it very informative. Cheers.